Now we will go to a documentary about the Khilafat of Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmed, the fourth Khalifa of the Promised Messiah.
The 18th of December, 1928, was a great day for the Jamaat. The first train was about to arrive from Amritsar, and in this manner, the movement would become more known in India. This town once belonged to Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, alayhi salam, who claimed to be the promised Messiah and Mahdi. His son and the second successor of the movement was now leading his cause. This day also brought further good news for Hazrat Mirza Bashiruddin Mahmud Ahmad and his wife, Hazrat Maryam Siddiqa. It was the birth of their son, Sahibzada Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmad. Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmad grew up as a happy child, ready to play and take up any challenge thrown at him. His mother wanted him to be a doctor or physician, but he was never interested in pursuing such a career. He was more keen on learning about human affairs and social works. He was interested in literature and developed a deep interest in the study of the Holy Quran. He started studying Darwin's theory of evolution. Although he had no doubts about Islam or the existence of God, he started investigating the existence of God on a logical basis. The health of Hazrat Mirza Bashiruddin Mahmud Ahmad, the second successor of the promised Messiah, started to deteriorate, and in 1955, he traveled to London to seek medical attention from specialists. Among others, accompanying him was Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmad. After the treatment, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih II decided to return to Rabwa, but he left his son, Tahir, now aged 26, in London to study and develop his social skills. He studied in the London University of the School of Oriental and African Studies and had the opportunity to travel to Europe. He returned to Rabwa in 1957. In 1965, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih II passed away, and Hazrat Mirza Nasir Ahmad was elected as the third successor to the promised Messiah. The problems for the community continued in Pakistan. Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmad worked under the direct guidance of the third Khalifa to deal with the problems the community was facing. In 1974, a legislation was proposed in the National Assembly of Pakistan declaring that Ahmadis were not Muslims. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih III led a five-man delegation to the National Assembly which discussed the proposed legislation. Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmad was the youngest member of the delegation, a compliment to his knowledge, insight, and familiarity with the history and traditions of both Islam and the community. On the 8th of June, 1982, his life took a dramatic turn when his elder brother, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih III, passed away. Nearly 100,000 members gathered at the headquarters in Rabwa. In accordance with the constitution of the community's electoral college, a meeting of the college was convened in the Mubarak Mosque in Rabwa to elect the new Khalifa. Under divine guidance, the Electoral College elected Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmad as the new Khalifa. Overwhelmed with emotion, he first took the oath in front of thousands. Then he took the covenant of allegiance.
Main Allah Taala ko hazir hazir jaan kar kehta hoon ki main Khilafat-e-Ahmadiyya par imaan rakhta hoon. اور میں خلافت احمدیہ کو قیامت تک جاری رکھنے کے لیے پوری کوشش کروں گا اور اسلام کی تبلیغ کو دنیا کے کناروں تک پہنچانے کے لیے انتہائی کوشش کرتا رہوں گا
میں آج طاہر کے ہاتھ پر
بیٹھ کر کے
It was during the time of General Zia that persecution against the Ahmadiyya Muslim community peaked. Their shops were looted and set on fire, and mobs rioted outside their mosques. The discrimination practiced by the Bhutto government increased. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih IV urged restraint on his followers, and he continued to warn Zia, but the general paid no attention to the warnings. On the 26th of April, 1984, Ordinance 20 was introduced under martial law by General Zia-ul-Haq. The ordinance was designed to prohibit Ahmadis from practicing their faith. Hazur immediately called a meeting, and it was unanimously decided that Hazur should leave the country immediately. Consequently, Hazur left Pakistan and arrived in London Heathrow. Hazur then established London as the new headquarters of the community. Within 3 years, realizing that the Jamaat will expand in a much bigger scope, in 1987, he started the Waqf-e-Nor scheme and informed parents from all over the world that they should offer their children, even before their birth, and then train them accordingly so that they become fruitful servants for the Jamaat. Once the new setup in London was established, Hazur was able to lead the community freely. The 23rd of March, 1989 marked 100 years for the community, from the humble beginnings in Qadian to over 120 countries in the world. The past 100 years saw the Jamaat grow from strength to strength. On the 7th of January, 1994, MTA International was launched and daily transmission started. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih IV maintained a deep interest in the administration and the overall supervision of MTA. Under his guidance, the channel progressed rapidly, starting its 24-hour service across the globe on the 1st of April, 1996. He personally initiated new programs and participated in countless programs, ranging from lectures, sermons, and question and answer sessions, to teaching the Holy Quran and homeopathy, catering for people of all ages and for a variety of languages. He ensured that MTA sought to provide an education and training medium unrivaled in history. His charismatic personality graced the screens of millions. The hurdles had now collapsed, and his message could now reach the community no matter where they were in the world. Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmed toured many countries. All these tours by Hazur strengthened and uplifted the spirituality and created awakening among the Ahmadi masses. Through his efforts, the community grew year after year. More and more people joined the fold of Ahmadiyyat, and many new missions were established around the world. The leadership of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih IV was characterized by vibrancy and dynamism that became the hallmark of his 21-year tenure of office. He spread the message of God. He was a fountain of knowledge. He touched the hearts of people. He was loved by both young and old. He was a man of dignity, an embodiment of love and peace. He was a man of God. Hamare